Hi, my name is Jose Luis, and in this video, I would like to teach you how to write functions in C# that can return multiple values and with different types. Because if you remember from previous videos when we learned how to write functions, you would remember that functions always have a return type, which means that this is the type of value that they can return, and it's typically only this one type of value. We can return multiple units of data by returning an array of values, but if we want to return different things, it's not so simple, it's not so straightforward. Like, for example, here I have an example that I've written where I created a function that compares two numbers, okay? And then it returns a Boolean value on whether if A, the first number, is greater than the second number, B. And then here I can store that into a variable because that's my return type, and then I can just print that to the console. So for example, here, is A greater than B? Yes, it's true. Okay, so this is great. It's just that if what I'm doing is writing a function that compares two numbers, there are many ways of comparing two numbers and many metrics that you can use for comparing those two numbers. So I may want to take the chance that I have this function that takes two numbers and then apply multiple things here to make sure that that I can return different things in this code. So for example, I may want to return the difference between these two numbers. So in this case, it would be the number positive 6. Or I may want to return a message, like a string message that says, well, 10 is greater than 4 as a string, you know, that I can use, for example, to print to the console or something else. So I probably don't want to write multiple functions that do similar things but return different types. It's kind of a little bit of an overload. That's a technical word that I don't want to use with functions here. So it's probably like a lot to do. So there is a trick that we can use in C#, which is we can use what's called the out parameter modifier for for arguments in a function. What that means is that what I can do is that for a particular function, I can specify that some of the arguments that are going to come into the function is going to write values in those arguments, and then it's going to return, not really return, it's not the right word here, but it's going to be, let's say that the values that are going to be written in that function are going to stay as part of the variable that was passed as an argument. And therefore, implicitly, whatever changes we make to the input to the argument are going to stay in that argument after that. This was a really complicated way of saying, I can write here a variable, so for example, difference, that is going to come here. I can change the value of that variable, and then that value will stay in my main program as an argument that I have passed to the function. This is because of how functions work in C#, because elements and value can be passed by reference or by value, which I'm actually not sure at this point if we have covered that topic in the videos. I need to take a look at that. But the outcome is that. So let me show you how that works. So for example, let's say that here, I'm going to add another argument to the function. This is going to be a double, and I'm going to call this difference. So here I'm going to store the numerical difference between the two values. And then, but what I'm going to do is that I'm going to say that this is going to be a parameter with the out modifier. What that means is that if I pass a variable here as an argument, I'm going to change that value and I'm going to return it back to the function. So for example, let's say that I add this to the out parameter. And then inside of the function, I say, well, this, so difference, which is already a variable inside of my function, difference is going to take now the value of A minus B. All right. And then here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to define a variable that I'm going to call, for example, diff, and then I'm going to pass that variable as an argument to the function and with the out modifier on it. What? And then if I now, for example, go ahead and here I say, can I console write line that the difference is this value, the value of diff? Let's see what happens. If I run this code, you can see that my output is difference is the number 6. Wait, but I have never defined the number 6 here as the value of the double, right? Okay, so let's take a mental journey, if we will, about what has happened here. Computer starts, we create a variable that has no value, so the default value is 0. And then what we do is we call this function with the two hard-coded numbers. And then we take this variable, a placeholder, we pass it as an argument to the function, and we say, with the out modifier, I say, I want to be able, if you make changes to this, I want to be able to keep those changes here in my main code. All right? Then the computer jumps to this function. It passes in the number 10 here, the number 4 here, and here as an argument, it passes this empty variable that we're using as a placeholder. This empty variable inside of the function gets a new value, which is 10 minus 4. And that value stays because of the out parameter. We do I, A greater than B, whatever. So this function finishes executing, the return here true gets stored in this variable, but also the number 6 resulting of this calculation stays in this argument, which in turn goes back to the main code, which in turn keeps the number 6 inside of this variable. And therefore, from here on, this has the value of greater is true, but then here, the value of diff now has the value of number 6, which was created when the function was called and when that number was stored in one of the arguments that we passed. That we passed as a way of collecting data back on the main code. Was that clear? Did I make a good point there? Okay, let's see another example. Let's say that I want to have a string with a message that tells me exactly what the comparison between those two is. So for example, here, out string message, for example. And then here, I'm going to paste a bunch of code that we already are familiar with. So for example, if A is greater than B, then the message is A is greater than B. Otherwise, A is smaller than B. Otherwise, A is equal to B. And I'm storing each one of these three messages in the variable in the argument that has the out modifier. And now here, what I can do is I can create an empty variable before and then pass that variable to the function as a placeholder to collect the data that has been generated inside of the function. Okay, it's like a net, like you throw the net, you pick up stuff that is happening inside of the function. And then after that, I can print to the console the message, right? And if I run this code, you can see that, yes, 10 is greater than 4, the difference is number 6. And now, for example, I'm going to say number 3, and then, yeah, is A greater than B? No, 3 is smaller than 4, the difference is minus 1. Okay? Alrighty. I think that was it, except for one thing. This idea of defining a variable beforehand and then filling it in with data that has been generated in the function is a very common way of calling and managing this function, because these variables might be variables that we are working with in the function or in our main program, and that are they keep changing value when we call compare multiple times, whatever. So maybe this variable was living and was created somewhere far away, and now we are just populating it with data using this function. But if we are creating these two variables explicitly only for this one time that we're going to call compare here, then we can shorthand this, and then we can create that variable on the spot. This is just a shortcut that I'm touching you here. We can avoid creating them beforehand, And we can just create them on the spot by saying, can you keep the output of this argument into this new function, this new variable that I just created here in line by writing the word double here? And can you do the same thing here? Can I create a new variable called message on the spot in line so that I can store that value and then I can use it later? These two things are the same thing. They're just shortcuts of one another. So this is basically a shortcut. So this is one way of doing it. And this would be the shortcut, the inline shortcut for the same idea. Okay. All right. So out modifiers for arguments are very useful if you have functions that you know want to return multiple things. So for example, this function is returning a Boolean to represent whether if one number is greater than the other, but it's also giving us additional information. So the difference between them and this message that we can use. Okay. This is a fairly common pattern in C#. You will see it in many places. And it's a very popular one for returning multiple objects. Okay. Alrighty. Thank you very much. If you liked this content, maybe you want to consider liking this video, subscribing to the channel, and all those things that are commonplace these days in YouTube. And hopefully see you in some other video on this playlist or some other video in the channel. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.